What happens when a policy is surrendered for its cash value? The coverage ends, but the policy can be reinstated at any time. The policy can be reinstated by paying back all policy loans and premiums. The policy can be converted to term coverage. Coverage ends and the policy cannot be reinstated. When a policy is surrendered for its cash value. When you surrender it, it ends. Applicants for surplus lines authorities must fulfill all of the following requirements except, well, they must have property and casualties license. This is a New Jersey exam, so I'm gonna guess they must pass the life insurance exam for sure. Hold a bond as a condition. For licensure, I'm gonna guess they don't have to be a New Jersey resident. An insured owns a $50,000 whole life policy. At 47, the insured decides to cancel his policy and exercise the extended term option for the policy's cash value, which is currently $20,000. What would be the face amount of the new term policy? I'm going to say the face amount is $50,000. And extending, let's see. Oh, they decide to cancel his policy and exercise the extended term option for the policy's cash value, which is currently $20,000. Oh, what is the face amount of the new term policy? So the new term policy is gonna be $20,000. An insured purchased a life insurance policy. The agent told him that depending upon the company's investments and expense factors, the cash values could change from those shown in the policy at issue time. The policy is an, I'm going to say, it has nothing to do with credit. This, I'm not sure about this one. Don't worry, it will tell us what we got right or wrong at the end. I'm gonna go with interest sensitive. It could be annual renewable term, but I'm not sure. All of the following are duties and responsibilities of producers at the time of application, except duties and responsibilities of producers. Change any incorrect statement on the application by personally initialing next to the corrected statement. We producers do not initial next to the corrected statement. What is the benefit of choosing extended term as a non-forfeiture option? It matures at age 100. It allows for coverage to continue but beyond maturity date. It can be converted to a fixed annuity. It has the highest amount of insurance protection. This is a guess also. which is the appropriate action by the insurer if a prospective insured submitted an incomplete application? So an appropriate action by the insurer. Fills in blanks to the best of the insurer's knowledge. No. Return the application to the applicant for completion. That is the appropriate action. When the insured selects the extended term non-forfeiture option, the cash value will be used to purchase term insurance with what face amount? When the insured selects the extended term non-forfeiture option, the cash value will be used to purchase term insurance with what face amount? The same as the original policy minus the cash value, equal to the original policy for as long as the cash values will purchase, and lesser amounts for the remaining policy term of age 100, equal to the cash value surrendered from the policy. I'm going to go with that one. Which of the following riders would not cause the death benefit to increase? So, payer benefit, accidental death rider, cost of living rider would not cause, okay? Guaranteed insurability. How must a replacing producer respond to an applicant wishing to replace existent life insurance? How must a respond to an applicant? The producer must provide the applicant with a notice regarding replacement. That is true. Okay. Who is the owner and who is the beneficiary on a key person life insurance? So a key person is an employee for sure. So we know that number four is wrong. Okay. Number one, the key employee is the owner. That is wrong. Number two, the employer is the owner and a beneficiary. No. Number three, the employer is the owner and the key employee is the beneficiary. Actually, I read this wrong. The employer is the owner and the beneficiary because they're insuring their employee and they want to make sure they will get money to cover their loss if that employee dies until they can hire someone else. And the interest earned on the policy, on policy dividends, is not taxable, tax deductible, 40% taxable, or taxable. They are taxable as regular income, I believe. Which of the following is another term for an authorized user? Admitted. Oh, authorized insurer, admitted. Which of the following is not true regarding equity indexed annuities? The insurance company keeps a percentage. They have guaranteed. Oh, not true. Minimum interest rates. They earn. They are less risky. They earn lower interest rates than fixed annuities. I'm not sure, but I still think that they are less risky than variable annuities. We'll find out at the end. In choosing an insurance business name, which of the following would be allowed? A name which implies eligibility for individuals to whom coverage is not actually offered? No. A proper name which does not belong to any officers, stockholders, or executives? A name with the same pronunciation as a competing company, but different spelling? A name with the same spelling as a competing company, but a different pronunciation. I'm going to go with a would be allowed. Yes, a proper name which does not belong to any officers. I'm going to go with that one. If a credit life policy lapses for non-payment before the debt is satisfied, how many days must the creditor either refund the premium paid or apply it against the debt? That could be 30 or 60. Which type of misrepresentation persuades an insured to his or her detriment to cancel, lapse, or switch policies from one to another? I believe that is twisting. Switching is not a thing. It's not rebating. It's not false advertising. It is twisting. Which of the following is true regarding taxation of accelerated benefits under a life insurance policy? Taxation of accelerated benefits. Okay, so there's no... Okay. There's a 10% penalty for early distribution of the death benefit. They are tax-free to terminally ill insured. They are always taxable to chronically ill insured. They are always taxed. I'm going to go with they are tax-free to terminally ill insured. An absolute assignment is transfer of some ownership rights in a policy, change of beneficiary, change of insurer, transfer of all ownership rights in a policy. I'm going to say of all ownership. Yep, did I skip? Okay. An adjustable life policy owner can change which of the following policy features? Can change. The insurer, the coverage period, the mortality expense, the investment account. I am going to say the coverage period. What kind of policy allows withdrawals or partial surrenders? I'm going to go with universal life. An insurer goes bankrupt and is unable to pay on any of its insured's claim. Which of the following will happen? The claims will be paid by a nationally based program. The claims will be paid by the state life and health guarantee association. The claims will be paid by the state department of insurance. I'm going to go with this. The state life and health guarantee association. Employer contributions made to a qualified plan are taxed annually as salary, are subject to vesting requirements. It's a qualified plan. So that means that they are subject to vesting requirements, I believe. May discriminate in favor of highly paid employees, are after tax contributions. I believe they are subject to the requirements because I believe the qualified plan is regulated or has requirements set by the IRS. And a non-qualified plan does not, and that allows discrimination in favor of highly paid employees. But we will find out at the end. What is the purpose of establishing the target premium for a universal life policy? Target premium. To accumulate cash value faster, to pay up the policy faster, to to cover all policy expenses to keep the policy in force. I'm going to say to pay up the policy faster. What is the name of a clause that is included in a policy that limits or eliminates the death benefit if the insured dies as a result of war or while serving in the military? This is war or military. Oh, well, it's war or military service, yes. I expected it to say war or military clause. Which of the following authorities is in charge of investigating claims held against licensees? I'm going to say the commissioner. The commissioner believes that a licensee has violated an insurance regulation and decides to conduct a hearing. How long of a notice must the commissioner provide the licensee? For this, I'm going to guess 31 days. But also use hints. You can go back and forth between questions. So we put commissioner, but this question was a hint for our last question, and you will be able to do that on the exam. And I'm still going to guess 31 days for this one. An applicant for a producer's license has successfully completed all of the steps necessary to obtain the license. The soon-to-be producer does not want to wait until he receives his license in order to begin working. Which of the following is possible? The person can obtain temporary work authority. The person must wait until the license is issued. The person must apply for a shortened preliminary period. As long as the producer is appointed, he may begin working and a license will be issued with retroactive date. The person can obtain a temporary work authority. An inducement offered to the insured in the sales of an insurance policy that is not specified in the policy is an unlawful practice known as rebating, or it could be coercion. That is not specified in the policy as an unlawful practice. Rebating is definitely illegal. I'm going to go with rebating. The National Do Not Call Registry was created to regulate telemarketers. What is the clause that describes the method of paying the death benefit in the event that the insured and beneficiary are both killed in the same accident? I would have said second to die, but I'm going to call this. This is tricky. I don't know this one. Let's guess. Let's look for clues. Well, I'm going to say the settlement clause. Because maybe this is about where the money goes to. It could be common disaster, but this makes me think a natural disaster. Maybe it's a common disaster. Like if it's because it's shared in common with the beneficiary. I don't know. Let's go with common disaster. An insurer receives an annual life insurance dividend check. Annual life insurance dividend check. What term best describes this arrangement? Accumulation of interest, cash option, reduction of premium. So it is. I'm going to go with annual dividend provision because it says annual life insurance dividend. When an insurance producer negotiates for an insurance contract on behalf of a client, the producer is acting as a broker. Is this on behalf of a client? Yes. All of the following would be considered an insurance transaction except advising a policy holder regarding claim, negotiating coverage, obtaining an insurance license, soliciting a policy, advising a policy holder regarding a claim. Which of the following best defines target premium in a universal life policy? The maximum amount the policy owner may pay on a policy, the minimum amount to make sure the policy is annually renewable, the corridor of insurance, the recommended amount to keep the policy in force throughout its lifetime. The target amount is a recommended amount. During replacement life insurance, a replacement insurer must do which of the following? Guarantee a replacement for each existing policy. Designate a new producer for a replaced policy. Send a copy of notice regarding replacement to the Department of Insurance. Obtain a list of all insurance policies that will be replaced. Did I skip? No, okay. All of the following are requirements of eligibility for Social Security disability income benefits except, be careful. Fully insured status, that is definitely a requirement. I'm going to say being age 65 because this is Social Security disability. You do not have to be 65 to get Social Security disability benefits. Which of the following premium payment modes will incur the lowest overall payment? Lowest overall. I'm going to go with annual. Because more frequent payments come out to be more over time. So annual. Have the lowest overall payment. A policy owner fails to pay the premium due to his whole life policy after the grace period passes, but the policy remains in force. This is due to what provision? Waiver of premium. Which of the following products requires a securities license? I believe this is a variable annuity. What percentage of a company's employees must take part in a non-contributory group life plan? It's either 100 or 75. So a non-contributory means that the employer pays the premium, so 100% of the employees have to be covered. Yes, 100% of the employees have to be covered so that, because this reduces the risk of adverse selection. If an insured under a variable life insurance policy dies, how will the insurer respond to the outstanding policy loans? The loan amounts are deducted from the death benefits. I would assume that. The policy is withheld until payments are met. No. The loan amount is charged to the beneficiaries. No. The loans are waived. I'm going to stick with the loans are deducted from the death benefit. I'm 90% sure about that. Which of the following applicants would not qualify for a KEO plan? I don't know how to pronounce that. Someone who works for a self-employed individual. Someone who works for 100 hours per year. Someone who has been employed for more than 12 months. Someone who is over 25. I'm going to go with someone who works 400 hours per year. Using names or titles that have the tendency to misrepresent the true nature of a policy is an example of what illegal practice? False advertising. Which of the following is incorrect concerning a non-contributory group plan? The employee is incorrect, okay? So we know the employer pays 100% of the premium. It says the employees receive individual policies. They help to reduce adverse selection against the insurer. That is true. They require 100% employee participation. So that is also true. And that's a clue that if you were taking the actual exam and you had got the previous question wrong, you can also mark the questions so you know you can go back. But we have the answer correct. It's 100%. So going back where we were, this leaves us with the employees receive individual policies. That is not true. They get a certificate instead of insurance. To sell variable life insurance policies, an agent must receive all of the following except FINRA registration, a securities license, a life insurance license, SEC registration. This is about variable life insurance. I believe this is a SEC registration. If it's not SEC, I believe it's SEC. Under the Fair Credit Reporting Act, individuals rejected for insurance due to information contained in a consumer report are entitled to obtain a copy of the report from the party who ordered it. Must be advised that the copy of the report is available to anyone who requested. That's not true. May sue the reporting agency in order to get inaccurate data corrected. Must be informed of the source of the report. I'm going to say you must be informed of the source of the report. The premiums paid by the employer in a business life insurance policy are always taxable to the employee, never taxable to the employee, tax deductible by the employer, tax deductible by the employee. I'm going to say never taxable to the employee. Premiums paid by the employer in a business, right? Let's see. Yeah, they're not tax deductible. I'm going to go with never taxable. A non-resident producer decides to conduct business under an assumed name. Which of the following is true? I've never seen this question before. The assumed name must be filed with the NAIC, the commissioner of the domicile state, and the commissioner of the state for which the non-resident producer's license. Non-resident producers may not conduct business under any name besides legal names. The assumed name must be submitted on the uniform assumed title form with an appropriate fee. I'm going to go with number one. Which of the following was created to protect policy owners, insured, and beneficiaries under insurance contracts when insurers fail to perform contractual obligations due to financial impairments? Which of the following was created to protect policy owners, insured, and beneficiaries when insurers fail to perform contractual obligations? I'm going to say New Jersey Life and Healthy Guarantee Association. An insured purchased a life insurance policy on his life, naming his wife as the primary beneficiary and his daughter as contingent beneficiary. Under what circumstances could the daughter collect the benefit if the primary beneficiary predeceased the insured? Yes. All of the following could be considered rebates if offered to an insured and the sale of insurance except an offer of employment, stock, securities, or bonds, an offer to share commissions generated by the sale, dividends from a mutual insurer. Dividends from a mutual insurer. Which is generally true regarding insurers who have been classified as preferred risk. They keep a higher percentage of any interest earned on their policies. False. Their premiums are lower. That's definitely true. They can borrow a higher amount. Not true. They can decide when to pay their monthly premium. Their premiums are lower. Which type of life insurance policy allows the policy owner to pay more or less than the planned premium? More or less. Straight whole life, universal, variable, or decreasing. I'm going to pick variable. Which of the following entities established the do not call registry? The Consumer Protection Agency, the Federal Trade Commission, the Better Business Bureau, the NAIC. It's the FTC, the Federal Trade Commission. A producer's license was revoked as the result of the insurance code violation. Which of the following is true? The producer can apply for a new license. The producer's license can be returned after 1 year. The producer cannot apply for a license reinstatement once the license has been revoked. The producer will have to wait 5 years before applying for license reinstatement. For this one, I don't know, but I'm going to guess that if your license is revoked, it cannot be reinstated. Which of the following is true about the 10-day free look period in a life insurance policy? It is optional? No. It begins when the policy is delivered. It begins when the application is signed. It applies only to term. That's not true. It begins when the policy is delivered. The minimum interest rate on an equity indexed annuity is often based on equity indexed annuity. And I'm sorry, guys, if you hear snoring in my background, it is late at night. And my relative is sleeping on the couch, but just ignore that and listen to my voice. The minimum interest rate on an equity indexed annuity is often based on equity indexed annuity interest rate. I'm gonna go with an index like standard and Poor's 500. Yes, I think that is correct. What is the purpose of a disclosure statement in life insurance policies? Disclosure statement in life insurance policies. To explain features and benefits of a proposed policy to the consumer. To obtain important underwriting information from the applicant. That's not true. To help consumers compare policy prices, that sounds like the buyer's guide. To protect agents and insurers against lawsuits. This is a disclosure statement, so I'm going to go with agents and insurers against lawsuits. But it could be number one. It actually might be, but let's mark that. Okay, it's marked. Okay, yes. Which of the following is not a duty of the commissioner? Suspending or revoking licenses of insurance code violators, developing insurance rates, establishing a system of insurer and producer examinations, enforcing the insurance code. The commissioner does not develop insurance rates. Who does an insurance agent represent? The insurer, the insurance company. What is the fine for violating the commissioner's cease and desist order? $5,000. The requirement that agents must account for on all insurance funds collected and are not permitted to commingle those funds with their own is known, commingle those funds with their own is known as, I'm going to say number four. Number one is premium accountability insurance related conduct, fiscal responsibility, fiduciary responsibility. So, let's see. The requirement that agents must account for all insurance funds are right and are not permitted to commingle those funds with their own is known as. Yes, I'm going to stick with this. Which of the following is a person or organization that is allowed to write business in New Jersey for insurance companies that do not possess a certificate of authority in New Jersey if no authorized insurers in New Jersey offer the specific type of insurance in question? Oh, I don't know. Perhaps it is number one. But let's mark that question. The initial amount of credit life insurance may not exceed the borrower's annual income, the amount to be repaid under the contract, the amount set by statute and adjusted regularly for inflation, the borrower's monthly income. I'm going to say the amount to be repaid under the contract. The insured under a $100,000 life insurance policy with a triple indemnity rider for accidental death was killed in a car accident. It was determined that the accident was his fault. The triple indemnity rider in this policy specifies that the death must not be contributed to by the insured in any manner. In this case, what will the policy beneficiary receive? I'm going to go with $0. Within how many days of requesting an investigative consumer report must an insurer notify the consumer in writing that the report will be obtained? 3 days. I'm 90% sure it's 3 days, but if not, it's 5 days. But I believe it's 3 days. Which of the following statements is true concerning the accidental death rider? It is also known as the triple indemnity rider. That could be true. This rider is only available to insurers over the age of 65. I doubt that. It is only available in group insurance. It will pay double or triple the face amount. Well, let's go see. What did we just read about? Triple indemnities. Okay, I'm going to go with, it is also known as the triple indemnity rider, and that is based off the previous question. When may an insurance company use suicide as a defense against paying a death claim? Only when there was a witness to the event? No. At any time suicide can be proven? At no time when death occurs within the specified time period after the policy was issued? That is the answer. You cannot buy life insurance today and kill yourself tomorrow. I believe that it's 2 years, but that would be specified by the insurer. An insurer must keep all sales materials for at least how long? 5 years. An insurer that holds a certificate of authority in the state in which it transacts business is considered a authorized insurer. Proceeds from life insurance policies are protected from the beneficiary's debts under all of the following circumstances, except the amount of debt exceeds the policy's face value, the amount of debt exceeds 50% of the policy's face value. There are no circumstances under which proceeds are protected from the beneficiary's debts. There are some of the premiums were paid in an attempt to defraud creditors. Okay, let me read this question carefully. Proceeds from life insurance policies are protected from the beneficiary's debts. There are no circumstances under which proceeds are protected from the beneficiary's debts. The type of settlement option which pays throughout the lifetime of two or more beneficiaries is called. It is either joint and survivor or joint. It is not fixed period or fixed amount. So two or more beneficiaries, I'm going to go with joint and survivor. The Supreme Court stated that insurance is interstate commerce and is therefore subject to regulation by the federal government in the decision of what case? Number one is the answer. And one thing about this one, Paul versus Virginia, I believe it was determined that that insurance, so in Paul versus Virginia, this is a story about someone who refused to get a life insurance license and was thrown in jail and fined, I think, $50. And I believe that in this case, it was determined that states regulate or should regulate insurance, and I believe that was overturned with the first one. If this question comes up as incorrect, then the two cases are flip-flop. But I'm, again, 90% sure that number one is the correct answer. The U.S. versus the Southeastern Underwriters Association. And this, actually, I'm 99% sure because ruling number one came, I believe, 75 years after ruling number four. Which of the following is a generic consumer publication? Those are keywords. Generic consumer publication that explains life insurance in general terms in order to assist the applicant in the decision-making process. That's a buyer's guide. All of the following are requirements for life insurance illustrations, except, so they must identify non-guaranteed values, must differentiate between guaranteed and projected amounts. They must be a part of the contract. They may only be used as approved. That is not true. What is the minimum age that an insurance producer can be licensed in New Jersey? 18. A licensee violates an insurance regulation. A hearing is held and a person is found guilty. If this is the person's first offense, the penalty is no more than $5,000. Which of the following information about the applicant is not included in the general information section of the application for insurance? So there's two sections, general and medical. So medical is not included in the general section. And the general is name, age, occupation, general. An insured will be allowed to reactivate her lapse life insurance policy if action is taken within a certain period of time. That's called the grace period. And proof of insurability is provided. Which policy provision allows this? Oh, this is a policy provision though. So it's not the grace period. So that's reinstatement provision. When an insurance producer sustains a spinal cord injury in a car wreck, he is rendered permanently disabled. In order to continue his business, his wife establishes an agreement with another producer to continue his business. The authorization will last for a maximum of 180 days. All of the following are true regarding rebates, except dividends are not considered to be rebates. Rebates are allowed if it is in the best interest. Rebates are illegal, so they're not allowed. Oh, it says rebates are only allowed if specifically stated in the policy. That would be something different. Rebating can be anything of monetary value, giving as an inducement to purchase insurance. This is correct. So number two is correct. Rebates are allowed if it is in the best interest of the client. So this means this is not true because they are not allowed just because they're in the best interest of the client. Rebating is, once again, illegal. A prospective insured receives a conditional receipt but dies before the policy is issued. The insurer will automatically pay the policy proceeds. Pay the policy proceeds only if it would have issued the policy. That's the answer. Pay the policy proceeds up to an established limit. Not pay the policy under any circumstances. If after underwriting a policy would have been issued, then they will, and the premium has been paid, then they will pay the policy proceeds. Going back to our marked questions, just to reconsider our answers. Which of the following is a person or organization that is allowed to write business in New Jersey? For insurance companies that do not possess a certificate of authority in New Jersey. See, I would have thought this was, well, if no authorized insurers in New Jersey offer this specific type of insurance, I'm going to stick with my answer. And we got a 74. So that would be a pass. Now we can see what questions we got wrong. Applicants for surplus lines authority must fulfill all of the following requirements except hold a bond as a condition for licensure. An insured owns a $50,000 whole life policy at age 47. The insured decides to cancel his policy and exercise the extended term option. So if you see extended term option, be careful. If the question starts to talk about the face amount of the new term policy, because it's gonna be $50,000. It's gonna be the original amount listed, which was $50,000. It says the face of the term policy will be the same as the face amount provided under the whole life policy. When the insured selects the extended term non-forfeiture option, the cash value will be used to purchase term insurance with what face amount? And the correct answer is equal to the original policy for as long as the cash values will purchase. With this option, the cash value is used as a single premium to purchase the same face amount as the original policy for as long a period of time as the cash will buy at the insured's current age. Which of the following riders would not cause the death benefit to increase? Would not. Payer benefit rider. Now, I would not have thought this was the one, because I believe this happens like if the policy owner dies, but let's read the explanation. Payer benefit rider does not increase the death benefit. It only pays the premium if the payer is disabled or dies. With guaranteed insurability rider, the policy owner can increase the death benefit at specified ages or events. Okay. This question wasn't clear to me. If there's a marriage or birth of a child, cost of living rider increases the death benefit to keep pace with inflation. An accidental death rider, if the insured dies from an accident, the death benefit is a multiple of the face amount. Which of the following is not true regarding equity indexed annuities? They earn lower interest rates than fixed annuities. If a credit policy lapses for non-payment before the debt is satisfied, within how many days must the creditor either refund the premium paid or apply it against the debt? 60 days. So the debtor must either refund or apply the premium against the debt within 60 days. What is the purpose of establishing a target premium for a universal life policy? To pay up the policy faster. I thought that's what we selected, but that was a mistake. Okay. Right, because the target is a recommended amount by the insurance company. And it does, if you pay it, it will keep the policy in force, but it's not your actual premium amount. It'll usually be more, to my understanding. The commissioner believes that a licensee has violated an insurance regulation and decides to conduct a hearing. How long of a notice must the commissioner provide the licensee? 10 days, only 10, not 31, 10. An insured receives an annual life insurance dividend check. What term best describes this arrangement? Cash option. Cash option allows the insurer to send the policy owner an annual non-taxable dividend check. All of the following would be considered an insurance transaction except obtaining an insurance license, right? That makes sense. Okay. A policy owner fails to pay the premium due to his whole life policy after the grace period passes, but the policy remains in force. This is due to what provision? Automatic premium loan. Okay. The premiums paid by the employer to a business in a life insurance policy are tax deductible by the employer. So the premiums that an employer pays for life insurance on an employee, whereby the policy is for the employee's benefit, are tax deductible to the employee as a business expense. A non-resident licensed producer decides to conduct business under an assumed name. Which of the following is true? Non-residents may not conduct business under any name besides legal names. Which type of life insurance policy allows the policy owner to pay more or less than the plan premium? Universal life. A producer's license was revoked as a result of the insurance code violation. Which of the following is true? The producer will have to wait 5 years before applying for license reinstatement. What is the purpose of a disclosure statement in life insurance policy? To explain features and benefits of a proposed policy to the consumer. Which of the following is a personal organization that is allowed to write business in New Jersey for insurance companies that do not possess a certificate of authority in New Jersey? If no authorized insurers in New Jersey offer the specific type of insurance in question, surplus lines agent. The insurer owned a $100,000 life insurance policy with a triple indemnity rider for accidental death was killed in a car accident. It was determined that the accident was his fault. The triple indemnity rider in the policy specifies that the death must not be contributed to by the insured in any manner. In this case, what would the policy beneficiary receive? $100,000. Which of the following is true concerning accidental death rider? It will pay double or triple the face amount. Proceeds from life insurance policies are protected from the beneficiary's debts under all of the following circumstances, except some of the premiums were paid in an attempt to defraud creditors. Life insurance policies are protected from beneficiaries' debts and liability. This, however, does not apply when any premiums are paid to defraud creditors. These will be owed with interest from the proceeds of the policy. All of the following are requirements for life insurance illustrations, except they must be part of the contract. An illustration may not be altered by an agent and must clearly state that it is not part of the contract. It is illegal to list non-guaranteed values in the contract, but they must be specifically labeled as projected not guaranteed values. And with that, if you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe if you would like me to do more of these.